I think that is a time to change a little bit the subject, and let's discuss a little bit about women and about eternal women, starting with Mona Lisa. And I put it on my table some question. One, it's something new from the point of view of HIV/AIDS, like global data, especially from the point of view of women. It's so simple to access to specific care, and I don't want to discuss of cascade care, but cascade of surveillance and the services to women. Standard of care in Central and Eastern part of Europe, access to care of women who use drugs, and something about regional perspective in Central Europe. Okay, about HIV/AIDS global data. Like usual, everyone who came here starting with some epidemiological data, and I think that is very important because I try to understand in my mind after 30 years working with HIV and especially with children with HIV because I'm a pediatrician, in fact, I'm asking all the time if it's so simple to reach the 90-90-90. If you are looking at the global data in 2017, it's possible to see that, in fact, in life are more than 36 million of population, and from this, a half women. And like vertical transmission, we are on the same range, about in life, like children, about 2 million of children touched by HIV. Newly infected in every year, only children, more than 100,000 children in every year. Okay, about testing and continuum of care at the global level is very important. If we are the same in the center part of Europe, in eastern part of Europe, or all over the world, about testing, especially in the center part of Europe, it's possible to see that we are about 80% in treatment, but what about care, specifically in women, we shall see. In Europe, in 2016, the last data from ECDC Stockholm, it's possible to see that the, in center part is incidence and prevalence low, like usual. In eastern part of Europe is high, and in western part is in a sort stable. Like rate of new diagnosis in Europe between 2007 and 2016, from the point of view of women, the majority cases appear in eastern part of Europe and in center part of Europe is a moment of low incidence and prevalence, except Romania with a little bit higher numbers of new cases between 15 until 24, equal men and women between 15 and 24 years. But we discussed from epidemiological point of view, we have 30 millions, from this a half, about 80 millions are women. What can we do, in fact, about free access to treatment in Europe and generally speaking in the world? It's so simple. In 2015, it was a launch and study by Margaret Johnson. After ELA study, deployed especially in center part and eastern part of Europe, about women touched by HIV, and it was a real fight to see something about barriers to access of care, about knowledge about HIV in Europe, about risk factor in transmission in Europe, about age of women touched by HIV or new discovered in 2014, about the partner of women touched by HIV, and also, for sure, the data about treatment viral on CD4. And is this data from 2014-2015, published in 2015? We heard that the most important problem in Europe, it was stigma, like barrier for women. And also the information about HIV, and not only about HIV, especially in women, And in a family with, like for example in Romania, where the majority of the couple are discordant, one woman positive and a man absolutely negative, and the information about the transmission of HIV in this situation. Barriers and access to specific care for women of HIV in Europe. The majority of the answer, especially in Central Europe, it was something like fine. The majority of the women in central part of Europe attended, it was possible to be in care, for specific treatment, not exactly the same situation in eastern part of Europe. What it was launched like message? What is known? Barriers to care, such as transportation, lack of gender autonomy, healthcare system, stigma, economical constraints, it was a real, real problem in that time. What it was new from this point of view of ELA study? Despite of the advance in the health system, generally speaking, in Europe, after 30 years with HIV, women living with HIV still experience significant barriers to accessing to care. It's very, very interesting. Why? Because if I'm looking a little bit back to the other slide, it was something like this. In Central Europe, it's absolutely perfect. We have everything, but in fact, it's something is a question. It's true that it's so for women. Stigma is a major issue for women living with HIV. What next from the point of view of ELA study? It's necessary to be in the future effort, especially for women touched by HIV. After 2 years, 2014, 2015, now in 2017, HIV care in Central Eastern Europe, how close are we to the target? It was a material launch in 2018 after a meeting in Warsaw 2 years before, and the objectives, it was very clear, to describe the system of survey of HIV from women and men in central and eastern part of Europe. And what we saw? We saw something like this, that in 24 countries, it was no for, it's very, very interesting, for specific clinics for women. But it was used yes from psychological point of view, diet and peer counseling. As a question, the moment of entering in antiretroviral treatment, 10 countries from 24 countries, both men and women, enter in any value of CD4 declared to ECDC in 2015. 5 countries under 500 CD4 and another 9 countries under 350 CD4. Another idea about the target. From this morning, I heard here the target 90-90-90-90, and especially about the target of the moment between 2020 or 2030, when all the countries from Europe and the globe is possible to enter between 99% and 100% in treatment. But if you are looking at all these countries, it was possible to see that between 2014-2015, the majority linked to care, it was between 70% until 80%, on antiretroviral treatment between 90% until 87%, and undetectable viral load, 60% until 64%. In 2014 and launch in 2018, the availability, the number of countries who had all the drugs for Hep B and Hep C, it was absolutely different. And all these differences appeared like the moment or all these drugs were admitted in all these countries. But in 2017, it was launched another study, especially in center part of Europe, and especially for model of care for HIV-positive women in Central Europe, and we saw something like this. HIV clinics for women now in all countries, the same like in 2014, about standard of care or cascade of care. is the same thing? I think this is not the same thing. Integrated HIV gynecology care in the majority with no in their centers. HIV testing in pregnancy, yes and no, depends on the countries and depends on epidemiological, especially in women in all these countries. And cervical cancer screening, yes or no, but the majority no for the majority of the countries from center part of Europe. Main barriers for women touched by HIV and about how it's possible to change the game, like in tennis. Main barriers in 2017, declared by the countries in the workshop meeting, starting with stigma, educational barriers, fear, lack of integrated services, until cultural barriers. It is very important because one is in center part of Europe, one is in other part of Europe. 4, access to care of women who use drugs in Europe. For some of the countries, nothing new. But for example, for Romania, it's absolutely new. And I saw in some presentation from starting with this morning that Romania, it was mentioned like HIV, Hep B, and especially Hep C and drug users, mainly in men, because the majority of the cases declared are in men. But in fact, the women are coming came in Romania late in sanitary system, not because it is forbidden, because of the fear of the stigma and lack of culture about HIV and about Hep C. And a study named Access to Treatment for Women with Substance Abuse in Eastern Europe is very interesting. In 2012, from Ecuador study, until this INSEST study deployed in Slovenia, Croatia, Czech Republic, Poland, and Romania, and in other four countries, in Israel, South Africa, Malaysia, and Indonesia. It was very important to preserve the moment of teamwork, especially from these five countries, especially from center part of Europe, when the specialized try to analyze the services offered to women touched by HIV and IV, new IV drug users. Very interesting in the center part of Europe. And what is possible to see? Only Slovenia is yes for do you have special services for women with addiction? Yes and no, is only one country. Do you have separate facilities for pregnant addicted women? Yes or no, only Slovenia. Is substantially free of charge for pregnant women? Are newborn babies survive for withdrawal syndrome? This is very important because it's totally different. I shall explain in some minutes. And do they receive treatment as like in guidelines? It's about the neonates who are coming from mother who are new addicted to drugs, especially in center part of Europe. And why is very important? Because in center part of, in some countries, like for example, like in Romania, and far as I know, also like in Bulgaria, appeared from 2010-2011 a new type of using of drugs, the so-called ethnobotanical neurostimulant of catinone, and is absolutely impossible or difficult, not exactly impossible, difficult to treat the neonates from this addicted mother. Results. The combined data set included more than 100 million people, which represent nearly the 70% part of Eastern Europe population, is very important. Drug abuse was more common in male than in female, but it was very difficult to reach the majority of the women touched by HIV and who are in that time consuming the new drugs. But when IV drug use was examined, more stimulants use was seen in Slovakia, Czech Republic, as compared to Hungary, Romania, and Bulgaria, 33% of scatinone. Results. It's necessary to have a special type of services for women touched by HIV and new addicted to new type of HIV. And the answer is yes, but how? The future is very important. What I saw in my country, because it's normal to say something about Romania. Starting with 2010-2011, it was up suddenly from 2% new discovered cases of HIV and IV drug users to more than 15 until 20% of new drugs, the so-called neurostimulant drugs. And in the same time, if you are looking downstairs, IV drug user cases reported, for example, in 2016 from this, 82%, it was with HIV and Hep C, 82%, and remain the same number in 2017 and at the end, at the middle of 2018. And also 32% HIV and TB, but combined with this 82% of HIV and TB and 10% HIV and STI. And in this condition, a child born from a new discovered mother with HIV, Hep B, Hep C, it was exposed to HIV, Hep B, Hep C, TB, and STI. How can we manage in this condition? And this is a new change, in women touched by HIV. And the last but not the least, here we saw something very, very important, that it's absolutely for free HIV drugs in Romania, but 90% of the women came exactly in the moment of birth. That's why, if you are looking upstairs, HIV positive treatment in pregnancy in women, only 28%. And that's why, from statistical point of view, from these women, the rate of transmission, but only from this point of view, HIV and new IV drug users, it was in Romania about between 14 until 15%, like vertical transmission. 1990 in 2020, okay. And in the same time, HIV-exposed newborn from IV drug users developed a so-called lenticular-striated vasculopathy. It's absolutely unique in this type of neonates from IV drug user mothers, and they developed severe psychological problem in the future. Another problem, also about women, is something new. Antenatal screening in Europe. We are discussing here about HIV, about treatment, about new drugs. They're absolutely important. But a study in Stockholm in 2013-2014 and published in 2016, it was something like this, that opt-out screening strategy in the majority of the countries for HIV, Hep B, and syphilis, it was not the same, not for all countries. Timing of screening, absolutely different for women. Only few ideas and information about migrant women, ethnic minorities, and women with risk behavior, and especially women presenting late. The majority of the women touched by HIV who are coming from the new addictive ketinon are absolutely not late presenters, with millions of copy from Hep B and Hep C and millions of copy of HIV. Okay. Elimination of mother-to-child transmission in Europe is feasible in 2020 or in 2030, depends on the problem in each country. But the latest data launched by ECDC about NTCT, about women touched by HIV and their children, is not so happy in my idea, and also Romania is in the center part of Europe with the most important cases of NTCT, not many like numbers, but 99% appeared from new IV drug user mothers without any treatment from the point of view of HIV, and without any discussion from the point of view of Hep B, Hep C, STI, and TB. Okay, about vaccination. Universal vaccination in 26 countries, coverage about 90-95%, but in last 1 or 2 years, in some countries, like in my countries, appear a sort of movement against vaccination. This is very tricky, and not exactly only about Hep B, but is about, for example, measles in Romania, and also from the point of view of Hep B. ACDC guidelines, very important for antenatal care and also for implementing of national testing or the women for Hep B, Hep C, and HIV. What about HIV, Hep B, Hep C in women's HIV? A regional perspective. In 2017, like co-infection in Central Europe, Hep B, 10%, Hep C, about 23%, in a way equal women and men. Hep B is the last data, especially in chronic Hep B, 60% of the new cases. And heterosexual transmission, very important, and also mother-to-child transmission. In Hep C, the same situation, but more in injection drug users. Possible game changes like a local perspective. From linkage to care to linkage to prevention. Linkage to care to linkage to prevention. Okay. Some idea about management of young women of fertile age with HIV and Hep B. Why is this? Because Romania is absolutely unique. It's rate 1-to-1 in population touched by HIV, young, in life more than 30 years. It's very important to know about objective HIV, rapid undetectable HIV RNA, how it's possible to control the viral sanctuaries, and also the prevention for long as possible the immune system. From Hep B, rapid undetectable Hep B levels, and in the future, how is possible the seroconversion in HBS system. Okay. Stages, virological and immunological HIV status, viral load, CD4 count, antiretroviral treatment, yes or no, and it's very important the history of all the therapeutic line from the beginning of the 1990s until now, and also from the psychological assessment in the moment of initiation of antiretroviral treatment in a women is very difficult, especially in young one, new discovered one, and especially in new infected like IV drug users. Virological immunological HIV status, and from the management of the young women of fertile age of HIV and Hep B in Romania, starting of HIV status until HBV status, from the moment of discovering, of testing, discovering, start antiretroviral treatment, and for Hep B, therapeutical attitude and prophylactic attitude. Young women and fertile age is very important. What can we do in this situation? To assess HIV therapeutic status, to assess HBV therapeutic status, is possible yes or no, and how is possible to deploy all this information for young women. The therapeutical decision for Hep B, HIV and Hep B, and the decision of prophylactic attitude, vaccinations, and specific immunoglobulin. Management of HIV pregnant women from the discovery of HIV women and until with HIV and Hep B, and the moment of the discovery of HIV women touched by HIV, and until undetectable HBV DNA. Vertical transmission. This is another problem. It's C-section, yes or no. Breastfeed, yes or no. What about liver fibrosis? Antiretroviral treatment initiation with combined HIV treatment and Hep B treatment, and assessment of her sexual partner and post and pre-exposure prophylaxis. In HIV and Hep C for the women, starting with HIV until the same process for like in HIV and Hep B, and in HIV, touch women is important from negative until positive and until the last HIV RNA assessment undetectable for 5 years and out of records. And the last, and not the least, is a question for me. The management of the HIV pregnant women newly detected with HIV and Hep C. In all the studies, it's absolutely forbidden from DAA, but it's possible to apply this type of treatment in the last pregnancy trimester, yes or no? Yes or no? It's possible, because generally speaking, it's forbidden. Mandatory C-section, yes. Yes or no, yes. No breastfeeding, and management of HIV and Hep C women at menopause is the same with HIV and Hep B. But the most important for me is this question. Is possible to use their therapeutic line in a pregnant woman in last pregnancy stem cells? Thank you very much. And